I'm Gayle Laakmann McDowell, author of Cracking Coding Interview. Today I'm going to build a comparator that we can use to sort an array.
So while a lot of interview questions are almost annoyingly abstract, this one's actually super applicable. There's a lot of reasons why you might want to implement your own comparator. And one of the most common reasons is that you're sorting an array of some type and the computer doesn't know how to sort it unless you tell it. So it doesn't know how to pick which element should appear first. And that's what this case is. So we have this player class and we want to sort it such that the higher scoring person appears first. And if they have the same score, then fall back on the names. So let's refresh ourselves on what this return value of compare means. So here's what it means. We should return a negative value if we want X to appear first, 0 if they can be appear in either order, and a positive value if X is considered to be bigger than Y. So here, our logic is we want to say, if they have the same score, then use the names. Otherwise, we want to say if A.score is bigger than B.score, then we actually want to return -1, then A should appear first. Otherwise, return 1. So we can do this, and this works here, but there's actually a simpler or shorter way of doing it anyway. We can do return B.score minus A.score. So note here that, I'm going to write this, if X should appear first, X should appear second. So note here that the sign is what matters. The actual value doesn't matter. So doing this will give a consistent sign with this one. Because note that if A.score is bigger than B.score, this value will in fact be negative. If A.score is smaller than B.score, then this value will be positive. So it gives a consistent sign with this longer bit of code. So that's all we have to do. Now let's talk about falling back on the names here. Well, a really simple way of doing this is, you know, actually just fall back on the names. So just use the string comparison. So return string.compareTo, or a.name.compareTo, b.name. And that's as simple as it is. So if you look at how different methods are written, you'll see this kind of logic a lot where we do subtraction. So it's a useful kind of tip to know. It can make your code a little bit shorter and cleaner. So this is a really useful thing to know how to do. If not for your interviews, then at least for real life. There's, you know, the syntax will of course vary from language to language, but most languages should, at least most modern languages, should have some sort of concept like this where you can give the built-in sorting algorithm some way of sorting a type that it otherwise wouldn't know how to type. So look this up in whatever language you're going to be using. Super useful for a lot of different situations. Good luck.